I'm Ree Merritt. Join me for a special exclusive edition of Data Exposed, where we talk to Simon Sabin about SQLBits 2023. Hi, I'm Ree Merritt, and welcome to this edition of Data Exposed Exclusive. Today, we're going to talk to Simon Sabin, a data platform MVP, and he's going to talk about networking, developing, and sharing at SQLBits. Simon, hi, how are you today?
I'm very well, thank you very much.
Good, good. So I'm excited that SQLBits is coming up. So why don't you explain to us what is SQLBits?
Why? What is SQLBits? Well, I guess SQLBits was my brainchild along with another MVP 15, 16 years ago, where we were desperate to educate people. And so we started this free event on a Saturday at the local Microsoft building, invited a few hundred people, got them a free book by having a sponsor the event. Everyone walked away with a load of learning and a free book. That was 15 years ago. We are now the largest data conference in the world. We have 5 days of content with 200 plus speakers, 300 plus sessions over those 5 days. And I'm proud that it's in the UK.
Nice. And so of all those sessions that you mentioned, I know that Microsoft and the product group has about a little over 40 sessions. We've got a keynote. And then I think four of the, how many training day sessions do you have?
So we've got, I think, 30 training days. So the Tuesday and Wednesday, the way that we structure it is we have 2 days of full day training sessions where people sit in a room with a world-renowned speaker, presenter, or one of a product team engineering person, and they learn about a specific topic. So very training focused. And then the other 3 days are classic conference, splitting up between individual 50-minute or 20-minute sessions. And Microsoft have got 4 training days on the Tuesday and Wednesday. There's a great one, which is currently very popular, the most popular one at the moment, which is a SQL 22 one with Bob Ward and Buck Woody. So that, nice. if people want to know about SQL 2022, like, it's definitely the place to go.
So I have attended that session with Bob and Buck because we took it to a couple of places kind of to like road test it here in the United States. So it really, really is a good session. So it's worth it. And this year is also for SQLBits is hybrid, right? So some in person or virtual.
Absolutely. I mean, I think so. SQLBits, we have for 15 years we've recorded content and we've given it away for free afterwards. I mean, it's a core facet about what SQLBits is about. Is about getting things to people for that can't get there if they haven't got any money. And so we've always recorded it. So we were lucky because of that when we went to COVID that we knew how to record, we knew some of those things. So we did a whole fully virtual one 2 years ago. Last year we did a hybrid one. And this year we decided, even though there's a huge demand for people to actually meet people physically, sort of right, touch them, that we would do a hybrid. And I think it really goes to one of our ethos about accessibility in that hybrid gives us the ability to not only enable remote attendees, but also remote speakers. So those people that can't attend because cost of travel is really expensive, cost of accommodation is expensive. So, I mean, as an event, we're, I think, probably one of the cheapest. Even though we're the best, but on top of that, with all the accommodation stuff, so people attending virtually is definitely something we're pushing very hard this year, and it's nice to see that we're getting, I think it's about 20% virtual, so nice. There's a lot of attendance, and a lot of attendance in person, which is going to be great.
Right. So why don't you tell me why you think learning like this at a conference, either virtual or in person or whatever, why is learning like this so important?
So I think SQLBits has got an approach that it's all about the attendee. If you go to lots of conferences, lots of it is about marketing and sponsors and exhibitors. Our focus is very much the attendee. And so the whole experience is about making it comfortable for those attendees. And a big part of that is that it then enables people to feel comfortable, enables people to learn better because they're more relaxed. We try and not overload sessions with too many people. So we've always like over provision from a capacity perspective. So rooms have always got lots of space so people feel comfortable learning. And so a conference like SQLBits is great from a number of angles in terms of learning about content. I said we've got like 300 speakers from around the world. If you are working in the sort of data space, predominantly on Azure and Microsoft, then anybody that you've seen a podcast, that you've gone seen speak, that does a blog, is probably going to be speaking at SQLBits. And the nice thing is, they're just like you and me in that they're just people and they really like to talk. And so it's a really great atmosphere to connect with those people, as well as colleagues. Ree, you've been a DBA for in the past, and you've been on the small team with like one or two DBAs and the big team with lots. When I started this 15 years ago, I was like the sole DBA guy or data guy doing SQL 6.5 migration from FoxPro. That was my sort of the project I was working on. And I had no idea where to find answers. Like it was just impossible. Like back in that day, like search engines weren't really a thing. news groups were a thing. And so trying to find answers was really hard. And I think that conferences enable you to connect with people that are in the same space. And so you can walk away with like solid learnings, like connections with world-renowned speakers and connections with people that are just like you and me that can help you if you get stuck.
Right. I can attest to how important it is at conferences like this to build your network. And so, for example, if you're going to a conference in person and you go and you attend sessions all day and then they're done and you head home or back to your room, you're doing it wrong. Bits is a standout in this kind of thing, right? Where helping people build that network, like you mentioned, being a solo DBA, you're not going to know the answer to everything, right? And you shouldn't be expected to know the answer to everything, but you can know people who are going to know the answer to everything. So you can have a friend who, a colleague or whatever, who's really, really good at optimization and one who's good at high availability and one who's great at storage. And they're going to be who you go to for answers. And you're going to look good for your boss because they don't know that you've asked Simon how to do something, right?
Yeah.
And Bits actually does that really, really well. I'm really pleased. So I want to circle back to something you asked me or something you mentioned a few minutes ago. And so I understand that the Bits committee has worked really hard and taken steps to make SQLBits an accessible event. Like there's a lot of different things that they've put in place. So can you tell us a little bit about the steps that you've taken to make Bits more accessible?
Yeah, I mean, I hate conferences personally. I find them, I get anxiety. I've got two kids that are autistic. I understand that like the challenges that we have as an industry, as individuals. And so we work really hard to make it like as a nice experience for people to attend as possible. We provide space so that people aren't feeling crowded. last year we provided a creche so that people that need childcare can come along and they can put their child in childcare. We've got a counsellor, so if people are nervous, have problems, then they can go and speak to someone. We promote diversity. We promote having multiple speakers because we think that encourages a better engagement, because you can have a conversation with two speakers. It's a much nicer experience. So there's all of these things that is really at the core of why, like, time and time again, like, your comments are just resonated by and repeated by everyone I speak to, that, like, in the words of one of our sponsors that I spoke to at the start of this time round, said SQLBits is the best conference on the planet, and it's because people come away and they just enjoy it. They get everything they need from it, from a networking and education and just, like, a good experience. And we're really, really proud of that.
So I've actually said before that I can go to any conference and learn anything. But I think people measure a conference by how it makes them feel when they leave, right? And SQLBits did a good job of making me feel good. I was happy to be there. I was happy to engage every day. I always had something to do and somebody to talk to and somewhere to go. And at the same time, it felt incredibly well-connected and intimate. It's something that I think, I don't know, not everybody masters. And SQLBits definitely has.
I think we are the industry. The people running it are from the industry. We are not a media company. So we look at it from a very different angle. And I think because of that, and interestingly, we say we're not here for sponsors and exhibitors, but interestingly, because we have such a relaxed atmosphere and people are in such a comfortable space, we find the exhibitors and sponsors have a better experience than they do at some of the other sort of harder sell conferences. And so, yeah, we're really proud. We've won awards because people find our inclusiveness just world renowned, and it's just something we work really, really hard at. And nice.
So let's wrap up with when, where, everything, all that. What do people need to know to get to BITS 2023?
So SQLBITS 2023, the links are in the description below. We are at Newport in Wales this year. We go around the country every time. And so we're in Newport, Wales this year, March the 14th to the 18th.
Correct.
You can come for 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, or 5 days. And if you come for the Friday, you can stay for the party, which is definitely a highlight.
Absolutely. Oh, so let's actually touch on Saturday is a community day, and that's always a free event for anybody to attend, right?
100%. So you can come to a full-blown conference, like full bells and whistles, breakfast, lunch, and it will be free. And if you want to stay over the night before, yeah, you can come to the party as well. You don't have to be a paid attendee to come to our free party. And if you want to bring your kids, bring to your kids to the party too. It's open to everyone.
Nice. So Simon, thank you so much for spending some time with us today talking about this. I'm really excited. I'll see you in March.
Yes.
There in Wales. We're looking forward to it. And so all the information that you need is in the links below. And thanks so much for tuning in with us today.
Thank you so much.